Aging is a part of everyday life. And what if things didn't have to be this way?
A recent report in the Sun USA revealed some of the super rich politicians that are also investing in projects aimed at reversing the aging process.
The Amazon founder reportedly made a significant investment in a company called Altos Labs.
Jeff Bezos isn't even the only billionaire interested in potentially living forever.
In 2021, the Altos Labs was founded. In one funding round alone, they raised a staggering sum of $3 billion, being backed by prominent investors such as Jeff Bezos. Their goal? Slowing down aging, or even reversing it. The Altos Labs will become one of many institutions which try to finally slow down aging. My name is Gimmons, and today we'll see how we can slow down aging, or even reverse it. This is the fourth part of our aging series. Each video contains different aspects of aging. You don't really need to watch the previous parts to understand this one, but there is more to discover. Okay, ready? Let's go! Surrey, UK, 1940s. John, I'm sorry, but you're the worst biology student we've ever seen. You ranked last out of 250 students. And you say you want to become a scientist? Ah, that's ridiculous. Little Tommy here might become one, but you? Pah! What? You might wonder how I got here. It all started with the research of some of my colleagues and me. But let's change the format, time for some science. John Gurdon is a scientist from the United Kingdom who worked with frogs. In the 1950s, he tried to transfer the nucleus of one type of cell to another type of cell. The nucleus is a part of the cell which contains the genetic information, or DNA. Cells of the same organism have the same DNA in the nuclei, but they have a different set of active genes. So this is why cells are different. One cell has this set of active genes and the other has another set of active genes. John Gurdon wondered what would happen if, for example, we put the nucleus of a gut cell into a fertilized egg where the nucleus has been removed. This means that a fertilized egg suddenly contains a nucleus where only gut genes are active. There are only two different possible outcomes. A. Nothing happens. Normally a fertilized egg would end up becoming a whole frog, but since its nucleus doesn't have any active egg genes, it cannot develop. And then there's option B, a frog develops. This would mean that the transplanted nucleus has to switch off its gut genes and activate its egg genes. If you asked scientists back in the days, probably most would have said that A, nothing happens, there's no frog developing. But when John Gurdon did the experiment, he saw something happening in a petri dish. A whole frog started to form. John Gurdon has just successfully cloned a frog. And he could show that the DNA of a gut cell can turn off and turn on genes in order to make a whole organism. His discovery became more and more important in the following years. In the 1960s, Ernest McCullen and James Till discovered the first stem cells in the adult body. They observed that cells in the bone marrow are able to transform themselves into nearly all types of cells we find in the blood. They named these cells blood-forming stem cells or hematopoietic stem cells. And based on their discovery, they then defined what a stem cell actually is. In order to be considered a cell has to have two different characteristics. The first characteristic is self-renewal. Self-renewal means that a stem cell needs to make other stem cells. The second characteristic is differentiation. Differentiation means that a stem cell must be able to transform into a more specialized cell. In the case of blood-forming stem cells, they need to constantly make new stem cells and specialized red blood cells and immune system. Over the years, more and more types of stem cells were discovered in the human body. Muscles contain stem cells, which give rise to new muscle cells, helping us to build muscles. We also find stem cells in the gut, which renew its surface and keep our digestion intact. And stem cells in the skin, well, help to renew our skin. While the stem cell community formed, they started to formulate some general rules. And one of these rules that the stem cells can make a more specialized cell, but a more specialized cell cannot make a stem cell. This in itself makes a lot of sense, because if a stem cell could just be formed spontaneously by any specialized cell in the body, we would constantly have new stem cells. But still, this dogma was wrong. Enter Shinya Yamanaka. In the beginning of the 21st century, a scientist named Shinya Yamanaka took John Gurdon's experiments to another level. Instead of transferring a whole nucleus, he decided to only transfer isolated genes. His goal was to convert a skin cell back into a stem cell. And not any stem cell, but a stem cell we find early in development. His theory was that if we activate these embryonic stem cell genes in skin cells, they might transform the skin cell back into an embryonic stem cell. Yamanaka and his staff scientist Katsutoshi Takahashi conducted elaborate experiments where they transferred more and more embryonic genes into skin cells and tested different combinations. For a long time, nothing happened. But when they activated four genes, they observed the formation of embryonic stem cells in their petri dish. This meant that stem cells could be created in a laboratory from more specialized cells. For their discoveries, Gurdon and Yamanaka shared a Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 2012. But their discoveries didn't only change stem cell biology forever, but also might revolutionize aging research. Our cells have to stick with us throughout our lives. Every day, cells are exposed to harmful chemicals and radiation, and some get permanently damaged. Many cells can compensate for this, but sometimes cells cannot, and they decide to destroy themselves. We constantly have to replace damaged or destroyed cells, and here stem cells come into play. Stem cells constantly transform themselves into various types of cells to replace damaged cells. This normally works very well for a very long period of time, since stem cells have developed special mechanisms in order to avoid being damaged themselves. They can enter a dreamlike state called quiescence. Here, stem cells do not produce new cells, but instead focus on their survival. They minimize their metabolism and gene activity and constantly remove old and damaged components. After a while though, they can reactivate themselves to perform the tasks. This means that not all stem cells are active at the same time in our bodies, but instead many are in a dreamlike state in order to survive for longer. And in this manner we can keep our muscles strong, our gut intact and our blood flowing for a very long time. However, this mechanism doesn't work perfectly, and as we get older, we slowly start to lose stem cells. Let's take a look in the bone marrow. We've said that blood-forming stem cells have to produce blood components in our immune cells. And in fact, they have to make between 100 billion and 1 trillion cells per day. This is an enormous task, and so stem cells have to constantly activate and deactivate themselves. And over time, they experience small damages in their genetic information or DNA. Over time, these damages accumulate and a stem cell can permanently lose its ability to create more intact stem cells. They might still try to produce cells on a day-to-day basis, but they become less effective in executing their respective tasks. And as a consequence, especially our immune system becomes less and less effective as we get older. Of course, this doesn't only happen in our bone marrow, but everywhere in the body at the same time. It might be subtle in the beginning. Our muscles do not recover as quickly anymore and we generally feel a bit weaker. We start to lose hair and our bones are at risk to be fractured. Then our immune system becomes less effective in fighting off bacteria or viruses. Sudden infections, which might not have been a big deal some decades ago, are potentially life-threatening. So in order to slow down aging, we need to fight the loss of productive stem cells. And this is what scientists are trying to do right now. After scientists started to understand how aging works, they went back to Yamanaka's discovery. Yamanaka discovered that we can make stem cells ourselves by activating a certain set of genes. So scientists asked themselves the following question. Can we use this technology to support stem cells or even generate new stem cells to slow down aging? A disclaimer, most of the following research, so research where we try to reactivate stem cells in order to slow down aging, has been conducted in animals or in isolated human cells. The reason for this is that this kind of research is still brand new, and before we go to humans, we need to collect more data. But still, the data we have already looks quite promising. In 2016, a research group decided to activate the same genes Yamanaka has activated to treat mice which suffer from progeria. Progeria is a disease where animals seem to age prematurely. Scientists hope to slow down the disease and slow down aging by activating Yamanaka genes. So in the first step, they genetically modified the diseased mice. Then they gave them a certain drug in order to activate Yamanaka genes. It was found that a brief activation of the Yamanaka genes was enough to make the organs more youthful and extend the life expectancy by 20%. This means that cells in the body can possibly be rejuvenated and the organism lives longer. In 2020, another team of researchers under the leadership of David Sinclair tried to find out if we can change cells to restore vision in aged mice. These mice had an impaired vision. So the scientists treated their eyes with three of the Yamanaka genes. These genes then became active and made the cells in their eyes more youthful. And astonishingly, the vision of the mice was then partially restored. The same scientists then also tried to find out whether this therapy can be used to treat vision loss. Mice which suffer from glaucoma were treated with the same cells. As a result of the treatment, the mice showed a higher activity in the eyes and were partially able to see lines on the screen again. And of course, the same therapy was used for human cells. Scientists then tried to treat cells from people with osteoarthritis. And also here it was found that cells seemed to become younger. And to this date, over 20 different types of cells of aged people were made younger. Based on this data, scientists now try to make this kind of therapy as safe as possible. And this is also where the Altus Labs will probably play a role in the future. Although it is not that easy. The main challenge is to make cells more youthful without going overboard. We really need to control which cells in the body we want to make more youthful. If we don't control the therapy effectively, cells might just start make new cells uncontrollably and possibly give rise to cancer. And then as a second scenario, if the treatment goes wrong, the cells might also be damaged and do overall more bad than good. So scientists are currently trying to establish safe protocols. But as we've seen in previous videos, we do not need to wait for scientists to develop new therapies. We ourselves have the power to live longer. Statistically speaking, at least. There are things we can do to possibly slow down aging and live longer. When it comes to our stem cells, we can do a lot. So here's what we can do. Number one, diets. Again, I do not want to sound repetitive, but our diets really impact every aspect of our physiology. Especially caloric restriction has been associated with a longer lifespan in various animals. Caloric restriction means that we decrease our caloric intake by roughly 20-30%. In this manner, we do not have to starve, but our cells kick off mechanism which helps them to survive. Caloric restriction has been shown to have a positive effect on many types of adult stem cells, including stem cells in the bone marrow, muscles, and the intestine. Right now, we believe that caloric restriction helps the self-renewal of our guts after a short period of time, and helps the function of our blood-forming stem cells in the long run. And if you're not a fan of caloric restriction, there are also alternatives. A ketogenic diet has been shown to especially improve the regeneration of the guts. Ketogenic diet means that we stick to unsaturated fats and avoid high levels of carbohydrates. This means that we especially might stick to plant-based fats found in nuts, seeds, avocados, or olive oils. But also, I've said earlier, please, no one should go overboard with this kind of diets. So if you drastically want to change your diet for whatever reason, go to a dietitian. Then there are vitamins. Dietary vitamins can also help to promote stem cells. Vitamin A has been shown to promote the maintenance of stem cells in the bone marrow. Vitamin C, on the other hand, positively impacts the gene activity of stem cells. But when it comes to single nutrients, I have to say that I tried to find some for quite a long time in literature, but it's a bit harder to really say what in the end happens in the body. So take that a bit with a grain of salt. Besides our diet, we can also exercise. Exercising, of course, helps us to specifically prevent muscle loss. That's a no-brainer, right? But it is also suggested that exercising can help to increase the number of muscle stem cells in elderly people. As a result, the muscle regeneration works more effectively and the loss of muscle mass might not be as great. But also here we have to be careful, especially when we get older, since we have a higher risk to suffer from sport-related injuries. Our stem cells help us to renew our bodies. Stem cells helps us to keep our immune system, guts, and skin intact. But as we get older, we lose them. When we want to slow down aging and possibly reverse aging, there are a lot of things we can do. One strategy would be to rejuvenate stem cells through special therapies. But also we can do something our own by choosing the right diet and exercising. Similar to developing stem cells, this field of research still has to develop. Wow, that was bad. But, as you can see, hopefully, we come closer and closer to understand how aging works and how we might slow down aging. With that, a question to you. Have you ever noticed your immune system, guts, or muscles improve when you start to follow a diet or workout routine? And with that, I hope that you enjoyed this video. And if so, feel free to like it and subscribe if you're new here and hit the bell button and do all the other great YouTube stuff in order to feed your algorithm. And with that, I'll see ya. This was the fourth part of our aging series. If you're interested in how to keep our DNA intact or how to get rid of zombie cells, you might like these videos.